heard of me? Well, correction, you should have.
That you need to manage, if you can.
The five deaths. Okay, this is as good a place as any to begin. Isla Matanceros. It's relatively stable. Yeah, you can,
I'm Cabin. You'll start by building a Hammond creation lab. We've already started on an enclosure for you. You should just attach it to the side. But watch out for dinosaurs. Ah, just kidding. Let's focus on what you're here to do, which is... is create dinosaur facilities on the islands we call the Five Deaths. Actually, Las Cinco Muertes, because Spanish is the lingo of choice around here. You'll need to connect it to the pre-existing network of paths and the power grid. Now comes the real test, incubating a dinosaur. You'll start with a Struthiomimus. Select the creation lab and pick a hatchery bay. There's enough genome data for your first viable dinosaur.
The machinations of the ambitious, undoing extinction, playing with nature's laws. What can possibly go wrong?
Come on, Doctor. You know we've learned so much and invested even more. Or in our Jurassic operation since the last time.
Yes, Mr. Finch, yes, the last time. There's always a last time. And a next. Life. It begins. The most precious moment. The result of incalculable actions and reactions, trials and errors, genetic entity, distinct and unique. And now we, you, just manufacture them. So, well done, I guess.
The Hammond Foundation has three main areas of interest. Security, entertainment, and science. I've already nudged the heads of each division to reach out to you personally. They'll offer opportunities and incentives for you to be part of their team. Choose one of their contracts. It'll help you develop your facility. This is Lambert, head of security.
Yours, theirs, and mine. Welcome to the islands. So here's our basic conundrum. We want to keep our animals under control while simultaneously encouraging instinctive behaviors, because these animals have potential as combatants. Look, everyone's fear object, myself included, is to have these animals running free and loose in the park. But we can't exploit them globally without taking some chances.
additional revenue to keep expanding your park. So, one more thing. Your reputation. Your rep, quote-unquote. Keep an eye on it, okay? If you have a solid reputation with a division, you're more likely to benefit from them. Financially, I mean. But, like life, it's a balancing act. Each division is vying for your attention, and if they don't get it, they tend to take it personally. Well done. And you'll notice absolutely no hint of sarcasm. Unless you listen real closely. So, what I meant to say is that completing that contract has raised your standing, your reputation, if you will, with the security division. This means they'll be willing to give you more difficult missions.
I'm Claire Deering, and I've been on these islands before. On Isla Nublar, I made some mistakes, and I've tried to set them right. I believe in what we're doing, and I believe in these dinosaurs. Responsible management of our animals is key, as is creating a safe environment for our visitors.
A new assignment that I think is perfect for your skill set. Give it a once over, then let me know if you're interested. Glad to have you on board. As you can imagine, the animals in the various facilities are constantly probing for weaknesses in our security systems. They're smarter and more devious than people give them credit for. But I refuse to underestimate their capabilities. That's why I'm always testing and evaluating our security protocols and barriers. And this is where you come in.
I've got to give this guy Lambert his due. He actually sees these animals as both opportunity and threat.
I'm going to need you to extract enough DNA from fossils to incubate and hatch a dinosaur. This is the first phase of this mission. Carry on.
I'm Owen Grady. Owen to my friends. I've seen things I'd rather not talk about, but it hasn't dampened my commitment to the dinosaurs. The raptors, more generally, and me and Blue specifically. We have a special relationship, like what I have with Claire. Less complicated. Anyway, nice to meet you.
The Research Center lets you improve your park in various exciting ways. New buildings, upgrades, and more await. An expedition center will allow you to send dig teams around the world in search of new dino fossils. DNA can be extracted from these fossils, which our scientists can then turn into living, breathing dinosaurs. And that's our true lifeblood. The Fossil Center lets you extract DNA from fossils and amber in order to create new dinosaur genomes. Exciting!
Добро пожаловать в мир юрского периода. Желаем вам приятного и безопасного отдыха.
Protecting our guests is, of course, our first priority. But our second priority is continuing to improve our security profile. And this new contract could help us do that. So it's important that you consider it.
good. Your first expedition team is out. They'll bring back what they find to the fossil center for extraction. Your job is simple, really. Create dinosaurs, which attract visitors to your facilities, brings in capital, money, huh? Which means you can do more research to build better facilities and create more dinosaurs, and there you go. A circle of life, development and resources, nature and commerce. See? Simple. You should extract genomes from fossils that have been collected inside your fossil center. That will increase the amount of viable data you have to create dinosaurs. Thank you.
I see you've hatched a Triceratops. Might be cute now, but that's only gonna last for about a week.
Ah, Dr. Dua. This is our new Director of Operations.
I'm aware, Cabot. I'm Dr. Dua. I run the science division of our operation. Okay, you're going to need to build your reputation in the science division. Not easy with me around, but you'll manage. That means managing our dinosaur population and seeing that they are flourishing. Be sure to take a look at your dino rating stat line. It's a critical snapshot of where we are. Where you are.
Okay. Next, you'll need to incubate the animal in a Hammond Creation laboratory before releasing and housing it in an enclosure. You'll also want to make sure we've got an ACU presence on this island.
Isaac, I've been hearing good things about you. I'm in charge of the entertainment division here. What good is the world's greatest show if no one sees it? Don't answer. That's rhetorical and painfully obvious. What I'm saying is that we need people in our parks. Fill up our facilities with warm bodies. Numbers bring revenue, excitement, and opportunities.
You must take care of your dinosaurs. Their health is of vital importance. My advice? Keep your animals well fed, especially in situations like this.
This one in the completed column. Thanks. Hey, it's Isaac. How you doing? I got some cool stuff you need to be a part of, so I'm putting it out there. Come on and help the winning team. Mine. Dinosaurs, we have one unlike any other on the planet. Theme parks rely on drawing people in. And what is more attractive than new dinosaurs? Well, me, of course. Yeah, no, what I'm saying is let's get some fresh dinos in the hopper. I've got a new offer for you to review.
What's worse, treating these creatures like grist for the mill or propping them up as curiosities?
One of your dinosaurs has failed to incubate. I never said bringing back dinosaurs was gonna be easy.
interests is what we strive to maintain here on the islands. We do that by making sure their needs are met. In a way, it's kind of like taking care of the dinos, just with more demands and less understanding. Am I right?
To be a prehistoric cage fight?
We reach the inevitable. Life begets death. But here's the question that you got to ask yourself. Was this avoidable? The answer? Of course not. Death, it's always coming. But could you have delayed it? Well, that's maybe another story.
Struthiomimus. Interesting. Another dinosaur that furthers the case of a direct linkage to our modern birds.
There's not a living being that doesn't require energy to sustain its life. In other words, food. Dinosaurs can't survive without it, and right now, they're starving. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.